Hello, Year 5. How's it all going at home? I hope you're doing well. What a lovely day it is today. Look at that blue sky. I hope you've all been outside in the garden or gone for a walk today. What I thought I would do is share with you what I'm making today. I'm making a pie. How exciting. I'm going to make a pie from scratch. I'm going to learn how to do pastry. Shortcrust pastry. I'm going to give it a go. I might not be perfect, but I'm going to give it a try. So, if you want to have a go at this at home, this is a great way to use some flour in the cupboard. If you've got some butter in the fridge, you could use it up. Right, first things first, you've got to weigh your ingredients. Luckily, I was prepared and I've already weighed up some of my ingredients. All you're going to need, some flour, some butter, and some water. Now, the recipe I got asks you to use 225 grams of flour and 100 grams of butter. But I'm going to make a big pie, so I need double that. Double 225. Anyone know what double 225 is? That's right, 450 grams. So I've weighed 450 grams of flour. And I've got some butter here. What's double 100? 200 grams of butter, that's right. Now, luckily, butter comes in 250 gram packs. So, if I need 200 grams of butter, and I've got 250 gram thingy, I can figure it out. I can use my fractions to figure it out. I've got my butter there. If I've got 250 grams, what fraction would 200 grams be, I wonder? Think about that for a second. That's right, four fifths. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a little line in my butter. I'd say that's about four fifths of my butter. And then really sensibly, maybe an adult can help you with this, I'm just going to chop my butter. Oh, there we go. And I'm going to leave that fifth of butter, I'm going to leave that for later. Maybe have it on my crumpets tomorrow or on a bagel or something like that. Now I've got my big bit of butter. What's really important in this recipe is that you use nice cold butter. If it's warm, it won't work. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to sensibly get my knife. I'm going to use my claw method. I'm just going to cut down into that butter. You might want to ask an adult to help you with this. It's a bit tough, but you manage. And another bit. I'm going to cut it like this, three ways. Oh, careful. I've got three kind of chunks of butter. I'm going to flip it over. I'm going to cut it like this. Oh, a bit stiff. I'm going to cut it there. Keep my fingers away from my knife. And cut it like that. Oh, you know how to cut butter. And then I'm going to cut it again this way around. What I should end up with, look at this, are some little tiny cubes of butter. And I'm going to just chuck them in there, chuck them in the flour. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention, before you do this, it's really important to really clean your surfaces. Wipe it down with some nice spray, make it all nice and clean, because we're going to need it in a minute. Okay, I'm going to get all this butter off there. Be careful with fingers on that knife. Again, make sure adults are there helping you out. Okay, look at that. All these big, nice big cubes of butter. See that? It's a good size. There's my thumb for a comparison. Okay, I chuck them all in there. Oh, that big butter. Oh, this is the fun bit. Now what you do is you get your flour with the cubes of butter in there. This is where it gets really fun. Make sure you've washed your hands before you do this. I washed my hands already. So get your clean hands and you just want to get your cubes of butter and you just squeeze it and mush it and mix it all in. It might seem a bit weird at first, but once you get your hands in there, it's quite fun. And you just squeeze the butter in there. Give your hands a bit of a workout. And you just start to see it sort of just combining with the flour like that. You see, squeezing my butter in. This takes a little while. It's not a short job. Keep squeezing it. Try and get the big bits all in there. Mix it up with the flour. Oh, it's quite tiring. You can manage that, keep going. And what you want to end up with is little, kind of like breadcrumbs almost. Breadcrumbs of flour and butter. And then we can start to put it together to make our lovely pastry dough. Oh, while I'm doing this, I can tell you what the filling's gonna be. Now, the good thing about this pie is you can think about any filling you want. You can use anything, anything left over in the cupboard, anything in the fridge that might be going off soon. Just whack it together. What I'm using is I'm going to be using butternut squash and or sweet potato. And then I'm going to put some goat's cheese, some spinach. So it's a nice vegetarian pie. If you fancy, you could use some carrots. You could roast up some potatoes. Just possibilities are endless. I love goat's cheese, it's one of my favourite cheeses, so I'm going to put some of that in there. Can you see now, this flour is starting to turn into like breadcrumbs. Yeah? I'm making a little bit of a mess, I'm going to make sure I clean it up later. Oh, and I like this little strategy, oh, I don't know. Rubbing it between your hands. And you don't want any bits of lumpy butter. Any lumpy bits of butter you get, just squeeze it out. And then maybe if you've got a younger brother or sister, you could say, oh, do you want to come and help me with my pie pastry? And it's quite fun. A lot of people say you could just buy it from the shop. Pastry is easier. I'll admit it's a bit easier. I'll give you that. It saves you some time, but it's not half as fun as actually making it yourself. And I think it's just tastier and nicer as well. Oh. My fingers are all a bit tired now, but oh, such a satisfying feeling when it all starts just to come together with breadcrumbs. The next bit is the bit where it takes a little bit of skill, intuition, a little bit of common sense, because it's not exact. What I'm going to do now is get myself a tablespoon. And I'm going to get some flour. Extra flour. I've got my tablespoon. Might just give it a little bit of a mix up there. Just check there's no more lumpy bits of butter. Okay. Excellent. Now, this part, you've got to kind of add water until it's the right stage. I recommend about 3 tablespoons, but I might end up adding a tiny bit more. Basically what you want to do is make sure that all sticks together, all the flour and butter sticks together without it being too wet, because then it won't bind properly. So I'm going to pour my water. This is just not cold water, not hot water, but kind of warm water. I'm going to put 3 small tablespoons in to start. I'll give it a bit more in a sec. I'm just going to give it a good mix. And now the water should start to bind together all of my flour, butter. Yeah. And once you use your spoon, you might want to start getting your hands in there. Can you see now? It's starting to join together a little bit. That's going to be for my dough. Now I think still quite a lot of dryness in there. Can you see? So I'm going to use a bit more water, I think. Maybe 2 more tablespoons. Oh, I'm making a right mess now. I'm going to do a lot of cleaning up after this. Just mix that up in 2 more tablespoons, I reckon. I think we're going to need about 6 or 7, as I expect. Oh, now you can see it all starting to bind and join together. Right. Now the fun bit, getting your hands a bit mucky, trying to get all of the dough together. Keep squeezing it.
Making pastry.
Get all that dry bit, those dry bits joining up with the wet bits.
Lovely.
Yes, now we can start to see a bit more of the dough. It's all joining up together. Oh, look at that. Can you see it? It's more like a dough now. Oh. Again, it's good to use your fingers, use your hands. I think I'm not sure if I need much more water, maybe a tiny drop. Tiny drop more water just to join the last bit together. Literally half a teaspoon, tablespoon. Here we go. Just get those last bits from the bottom. Can you see? There's a couple of dry bits in there. I want to join it all together. Oh. And that should be a nice big bit of pastry. Look at that. And important thing to remember with this bit is not to squeeze it too much, not to overwork it. Poor Holly would say overwork. Don't want to overwork it. Oh, you want to get all the, now this is where you can do, sort of use this bit to tidy up a little bit. Use that to get all your bits of spare bits of pastry and flour, get the bits off your fingers. It's a bit messy. Oh, and it should stick together and make a nice ball. Nice big ball like that. And I reckon I might just, yeah, no, I don't think I need any more water. Can you see there's a couple of cracks? I don't want to have any cracks in that yet. Otherwise it's not going to bind later. I'm going to literally put another drop on there just to stick it together a little bit more. Okay, oh, there we go. Just so the cracks disappear. When the cracks go, you know you're good. You're away. Oh, it's quite knackered. It takes it out of you. Oh, okay. I think I've formed my dough. I've made it. Can you see that's a nice ball of dough? Oh, there's a big bit in there. Look at my bowl. Clear. Nothing in there. And then once you've got your big ball of dough, you're going to get yourself some cling film. Again, you might want to ask an adult to help you with this bit. Just especially, oh, don't ask me because I'm going to do it. There's your cling film. You just want to wrap it up. Wrap it nicely up there. There we go. And what we're going to do now is stick that dough in the fridge. And you can leave that in there for a few hours. You can leave it in there overnight. Give it a good little good tap. Make sure it's all stuck secure in there. I'm going to put this in the fridge and we're going to see this guy later. Right, here we are with the next phase of the pie. We're about to start with the fillings. The best bit, the tasty bit. Before you do anything else, make sure you've washed your hands, number one. Number two, make sure you must have an adult keep an eye out for you with a sharp knife, either helping you chop or chopping for you, depending on how confident you are to keep safe. Now, I've already gotten started. I've already started chopping my veg and I put it in my dish, but I'm just going to show you what I've done so far. I couldn't get any butternut squash, a real shame. So I've gone with sweet potato, just as good. And kind of slightly easier to peel and chop. So what I'm going to do to start with is peel my butternut, not my butternut squash, my sweet potato. So I've got my bowl where I'm going to put my peel. And I'm gonna get my peeler again. Ask your parents to help you with this. Just gonna peel it. As you can see behind me, the weather's still lovely. Just been out for a nice walk. Out far away from anyone else. Over the hills. Lovely sunshine. Really nice. got my endorphins going, a bit of fresh air after being stuck inside. It's hard being stuck inside, but at least we were allowed to go out for a walk. Right, see all that peel coming off? Your butternut squash, sweet potato. I had it in my head I was going to use butternut squash, but just keep going until you've got all that peel off. Try and get that knobbly bit off at the end. There we go. Have an unpeeled sweet potato. I'm going to get all my peel. Just kind of dump it in my bowl. Or you can put it straight in the bin. And then we're going to chop our sweet potato. So this is where you've got to be really careful with your knife. So first of all, remember my claw grip. Probably use a bridge, but claw. Chop that nice and neatly in half. Again, if it's tricky, just ask an adult to help you that bit. And now I've got a nice flat side, which is now nice and stable, secure, it's not going to roll around. Use my bridge again, chop that in half. You might need an adult to help, it's a bit tough sometimes. And now I've got a bit. And I want my pieces to be similar sizes, but not just set exactly the same, but similar sizes, so they all cook evenly. Yeah? And the reason I love this recipe, this pie recipe, it's perfect for a day like today where you might do a little bit of homework, do some English, maybe decide to do a bit of cooking, make your dough, make your pastry, go off and do a bit more while your pastry's chilling, and then come back a bit later, do your filling, and then actually make the pie later. So you're doing it in stages, which is what I like. There we go. Just keep chopping, keep your fingers away from the knife. Remember, if you can't remember the chopping techniques, YouTube, claw grip, sorted. You just chuck in the dish there, the little bits. And I've got some onion. I'm just gonna chop my onion, keep your fingers away from your knife, chop the ends off first. And then I like to get my end of my knife, just do a little snick down the side so I can peel my onion. I'm using red onions and white onions because I'm feeling pretty confident. I like a bit of red and white onion in my pie. Get all that outside layer off. Chuck my leftovers in there. And with the onion, this is a nice bit. You can just sort of chop it quite roughly. Don't need to chop it. It's fine. It's all going to cook together. Chop it like that, so you get nice bits like that. You don't want it too small because you want them to sort of caramelize a little bit in the oven. You chuck all them in there. Do the same with my other white onion. Get that little end bit there. There we go. Peel my onions. Try not to cry. I'm not sad. Do you want to cry too much? Nick the end of that bit off. There we go. Chop those little bits. And again, just roughly chop. Lovely. Just lob it in there. And then that one I'm just going to chop it there. Watch your fingers. Next thing is garlic. Garlic is so important. I love garlic. I put loads of garlic in everywhere. A little technique you could use. Again, ask your parents to help you. Little garlic clove, just get your knife and your palm, crush it. There you go, look at that. Just chuck it in, do the same again. It's all gonna just go in the oven. Please make sure you ask your parents to help you with that bit. Or if you want to actually cut some up garlic as well, get the ends, there we go, peel it off. Garlic peel off, you're gonna have smelly fingers. Cut to those bits, and then you want to just chop it nice and fine. There we go. Lovely. Another bit that I peeled earlier. Just make sure your fingers are really far apart. Some of you might have one of those little garlic crushers. Again, probably easier. Probably quicker, but I I don't like washing up, so I like to just use the same knife I've used for everything. Again, this is really important to keep your fingers away from the end of the garlic. You can just sort of chop it. It's another good chopping technique. You just put your hand above there, fingers away. Just sort of mash up your garlic a bit like that. And I've got some other bits. Just a crush. And there's another bit. And now I'm going to get all of my bits on my tray and just wipe it in there. There we go. Messy hands, stick it in there. Now, got my tray, I can move my chicken board out of the way. Now we need to put the seasoning in here. I'm not gonna put it in the oven just like that. First thing I wanna do, big old glob of olive oil. Just all over there like that, nice glob. It's really important to have a bit of olive oil in there. And then, salt and pepper. Ground black pepper. Get that all in there. And then, again, the shop didn't have many herbs, but there's plenty of nice herbs in the cupboard. You can use any sort of herb or flavour you feel like. I've got some dry basil. Oh, it's not even open yet. I might not use it. I want to open a new one. I've got some thyme. All the thyme in the world. Hey. Just dash that all over the top. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention this at the beginning of the video. Oven is at about 180 degrees at the moment. I made sure I put it on before, so it's heating up. Now, I like my chilli flakes. You decide if you want a couple. I like having quite a few. Gives it a bit of a kick, a bit more flavour. It's really well, chilli flakes with sweet potato. And then the star spice, paprika. Oh, smoked paprika. Look at that. Just drizzle it all over. And then, again, here's the fun bit. Oh, all that paprika smells really good. A bit more. Here's the fun bit. Clean hands. Just get in there. Get in there. Maybe get your younger brother. You've done the chopping. Maybe get your younger brother or sister to just make sure everything's all coated up. Coat it all up with your fingers. Okay. Oh, the smell of that olive oil, of the paprika, of the garlic. Oh, it just smells so good. Oh, it fell out. And now, sticky hands, but look, that's gonna go in the oven now. I can't wait. I'm gonna put that in the oven for probably 30 minutes, 40 minutes. I'm gonna check, but as soon as it's nice and soft, it's gonna be ready. So I'm gonna put this in the oven now. And then I'm gonna go and check my emails to see if any more of you have sent me some work. And I'm gonna come back and check if they're cooked. Okay, so here we are with the next phase of the pie plan. Now I'm about to do the pastry, roll it out. Before I do that, I'm just gonna wilt some spinach. It's really important when you're wilting some spinach to make sure it's at a really, really low heat. I've got it on 2 at the moment. Really low. Okay, and you just let the pan heat up a little bit, ask an adult to help you, and you literally put a whole bag of spinach in there. What's gonna happen is it's gonna wilt down quite a lot. So you'll put a whole bag in there, just leave that lid on, and leave it there. Leave it, come back to it in a couple of minutes and give it a little move around to move the spinach from the bottom. But we're gonna leave that, just gonna cook really slowly. Don't wanna overcook spinach because it gets too much. Right. Now, we're gonna do the pastry. So, you take the pastry out of the fridge that you made earlier, out of your cling film. Should be nice and cold now. And you're gonna get some flour. And you're gonna need some flour and a really, really clean and dry surface. Got my bag of flour. You're just gonna do a little flour your surface. Spread it out. Makes a bit of a mess, but you're gonna need it. And then with your pastry, you're going to need to divide it into top and the bottom. And you're probably going to need about 2/3 for the bottom and about 1/3 for the top. So just with your hands, you can just split it up. I might have a little bit more for my bottom. Okay, put that bit to one side. And now we're just going to get our pastry. This is the fun bit, and your rolling pin, and you're going to just start rolling it. And this is where you start to see if your pastry's worked or not. So you roll on one side, flip it over, roll the other side, back and forward. Make sure it's covered with some flour, otherwise it'll stick to the surface of the table. Keep moving that flour around. And every couple of minutes, you just flip it over, put it onto the other side. And if it should be really cold, otherwise it will fall apart. It's got to be cold, otherwise it's not going to stick together. So you just keep pushing it forward and back and get adults to help. It's a bit hard work. And just keep getting those sides in together. And it wants to be about a centimetre thick. That thick. So I'm doing this while my veg is already cooked in the bowl. So I'm going to do my filling in a minute. Going to keep rolling it until it gets thinner. It's a good workout. Keep going back and forward. It should start to really stretch out. Just try and hold up the gaps. It should start to get a bit bigger as it stretches. And try and find the thicker parts and stretch those bits out. Ooh. Again, if you buy your own pastry, it's normally already rolled out, so you don't have to go through all this. But it's fun. It's more fun doing it like this, isn't it? But if you want to buy it and cheat a bit, that's fine. When you buy it, it comes out and it's like this already. Now, you want to try and get it into as big of a circle as you can. Keep getting it thinner. Thinner, thinner, thinner. Don't want it too thin because you don't want it to lose all the filling. So you want to get the right thickness. Oh, getting a good bit of pastry there though. I've got a bit at the end now. I'm just going to take that off. And take that bit off and I'm going to add that to my top. Oh, we're getting there. It's nice and thin, nice and stretched out. Just start to get a bit more delicate and gentle. Just be careful with it. Don't want to rip it in half because you have to start all over again. Oh, there we go. That pastry. In fact, it's probably less than a centimetre. I'd say half a centimetre. You want it? Now, I'm quite inexact with my measurements, but I've got two pie dishes here. I'm just going to test that which one would be the best. You want to make sure it goes all the way up the sides of your pie dish. Okay. That's my pastry. Oh, big now, isn't it? Or bigger. I'm going to start with this pie dish. I think that should be a good size. I was thinking about that, but I'm worried it's not going to go to the edge, so I'm going to use this pie dish. And what's really important to do first is to butter or grease, what's called greasing the sides of your dish. So to do that, you get your dish. Remember that butter we used earlier? Just rip off. Rip the packaging like that. Perfect. And this is a fun bit you can do. You get a couple of knobs of butter like that, and you get them in the middle and just squidge it all over. This is the fun bit. Oh, just get all around the dish as much as you can. This, make sure it doesn't stick to the dish. That's it all the way around, and it makes it look crispy outside the pie, which is lovely. Oh, get all in there. Oh, there we go. And with that, you should have nicely, what's called a greased pie dish. Now this is a little bit tricky. you might need someone else to help you with it. So be really delicate with your pastry. You just want to flop it in there and sort of ease it in. Don't be too quick, you don't want to rip your pastry. Your pastry wants to stay in one big piece. And then you kind of ease it into the corners. Slowly, slowly. You know, I probably could use that as a bigger dish, but oh. And then you should start to feel it fill in the space of the pie dish. Just like that. And then it's good to get another little bit of pastry that you've got a bit of a cut off and just use it to sort of push in the, probably seen this on Bake Off, and they do that and they push it in the corners. And that just means it doesn't stick together and keeps it nice and clean. So I'm just going to go around my corners and make sure it's really stuck to the edge. Can you see my pastry goes all the way to the top? You might end up wasting a little bit, but it's really important it goes all the way around to the top. Oh, it's going to be a good pie. I can feel it already. The pastry's feeling good. I was a bit worried it might not stick together, but I think it's going to be good, nice and firm, strong pastry. Right. Next thing we've got to do is blind bake our pastry, and I'm going to go check my spinach in a minute. Cold, you want to swap over. So can you see the stuff at the bottom? It's now starting to wilt and get a lot smaller. So you want to take the stuff from the bottom and move it up to the top. Can you see? It's just move it all around a bit, move it about. And again, you don't want it to get too small. Look how much it shrinks. Yeah? It's a really low heat, just keep moving it around. Okay. So that's, oh, smells a bit. Okay. Can you see how much it's reduced down already? Since before, I'll put the lid back on. Keep an eye on that, don't want it to cook too much. I'm also making a cup of tea at the same time. Look at that. Multitasking. Right, put that in there. My next thing I'm going to show you is, there we go, how to blind bake my pastry. Got some pastry I did before and some greaseproof paper, and it needs to be quite big, so you're just going to push it into the corners. And I've got some baking beads. I'm going to fill that up with a really, really, really heavy these. Great. If you don't have any of them at home, you can use a ramekin, something like that, a china ramekin, or you could use another little dish, a little oven dish, to just make sure the paste doesn't rise up. Anything will do, really. Again, make sure you ask your parents to help you. And I'm also going to get a little knife and just, again, with the help of the parents, just trim just the big bits of pastry off the side of my dish, like that. Just the extra bits. If you've got some flipping down the side, it's not the end of the world. Definitely ask an adult to help you with this bit. There we go. And when you do this, you want to put it in for 10 minutes, if that, just to bake it. Otherwise, if we've got a lot of wet ingredients, it's going to soak through into the pastry and the pastry will be all wet at the bottom and we want it to be firm. So we're going to put this in the oven for about 10 minutes. Again, this is where you need to ask an adult to help you. So I'm putting it in at about 150 degrees to start with. Make sure you ask an adult to put it in the oven for you. Meanwhile, I'm going to get on with my other bit of my topping for my pastry. So I get all my dough I've got together like that. I'm gonna get some more flour. I'm gonna do it all over again and roll out. Oh, keep an eye on that spinach as well. So I've got my flour surface. I've got my big nice ball of pastry. Still quite cold, still quite firm. And now I'm gonna do the same again. It's a bit smaller this time, it's a bit easier. Ugh. Tuck any stray bits underneath. There we go. Oh. Again, you want it to be nice and thin, but not way too thin that it's not going to hold anything into it. You should be sort of doing like a rectangular shape and then over it, flipping it every time. Keep it on the keep it on the flour so it doesn't stick. Ooh, tiring work all this rolling pastry. There we go. It's thinning out nicely and stretching. The thinner it gets, the stretchier it gets. Hello, how are you? Just make it so you know that it's going to stretch over the whole of that pie dish that's in the oven at the moment. Okay, so that is looking good. Oh, I can feel that bit there is a bit thick, so I'm just going to stretch that a bit out. This is really as well, it's a bit, not the easiest thing, make sure you've got an adult, do this with your parents. It's a good thing to do together. This is also fun for younger brothers and sisters, maybe you could have a little go at rolling. And there we go, we've got it nice and thin. So, like I said, I've drained off a little bit of excess liquid in my spinach. You don't have to do spinach. You could just do a more simple filling if you want. You could do meat, you could do a meat filling, chicken and mushroom, whatever you like. But I love spinach. I'm gonna put it in, it's nice and healthy, nice and green. So I'm gonna put that in with my sweet potato that I cooked in the oven earlier. Use some chopping, get all the bits out there. And I'll use that. I'm gonna stick that in the sink to wash it up. And so I've got a kind of orange and green concoction there, and we want it to be, even if it's pie filling, we want it to be quite nice and moist. Don't be too dry, so don't worry if you think, oh, it's a bit wet, this spinach. It's good because it keeps nice and moist inside. Next is my favorite bit. Yummy goat cheese. And this, you might think, oh, it's really dry, there's no sauce. This goat cheese kind of melts into it and it makes like this silky, creamy, just like kind of nutty flavour sauce. Just lovely. Goat cheese. If you haven't tried this before, it's really easy way to get into cheese. It's one strength. It's really nice and creamy. If you think, oh, I don't like goat cheese, just try it. Just give it a go. And all you need to do is just get a spoon and just lump it in there. I'm using a little spoon because I don't want to bash my spinach up too much. The more you move the spinach around, the more it's going to get damaged and get smaller, and you're not going to really notice it. So I don't want to mess around with it too much. I don't want to leave any goat cheese in there. I'm going to pop that in there. Get all that goat cheese out. So what I've done is I've mixed my goat's cheese, sweet potato, onion and spinach mix all in here. Doesn't that just look yum? And that goat's cheese makes that really nice sort of sauce. Nice creamy sauce. And all I'm going to do now is just tip it in. Ooh. And I've blind baked my pastry so it's nice and firm at the bottom. I did it for about 20 minutes. But that's the part you've really got to ask your parents to help you with. Okay, taking things in and out of the oven,
ask your parents. Do not do it on your own. Mm. I've just been picking the bits of pastry off the edge. But some of the bits overhang. Okay, that. But again, still quite hot from the oven, so be really careful touching that. So when you get your filling, again with a little, just a little spoon, you can just start to fill it in there. You don't want to overload it too much. You want to have a little bit of space at the top. Okay, and that's nice and spread out. Get my spinach in there. And then the next part is another fun bit. My pastry that I flattened out earlier, still there. I'm just gonna gently put that over the top, like a nice hat, pastry hat. And then just around the edge, just lightly press it down a little bit. I think I could have had a bit more filling, maybe made it a bit more like that. Again, don't worry too much about the little details. I always cook with a little bit of, oh, this will do, that'll do. If you want to be particular about it, you might want to think about how much veg you've used, the size of your pie dish. But now, this is the fun bit as well. What we've got to do is get a fork and just go around the edges. And then press that pastry down the edges. And that should firm it up so that all the filling stays in and your bottom bit of pastry connects with the top bit. Okay, and you go around. Again, this is the part where you might say to a younger brother or sister, as long as they don't touch the pie dish, do you want to come and have a go at doing this? It's fun. And some people have special crimping devices where you can make fancy patterns on the edge. If you got one of them at home, I'd use one of them. Okay, the whole way around the edge. And then, all the way around, there we go. I've crimped my pie. It's a good word, isn't it? Crimp, good verb. Same fork, I'm just gonna make some nice, gentle holes on the top, and what that happens is when it cooks, the steam from inside has somewhere to escape. There we go, some nice holes. Right, one more thing I've got to do. I'm going to get a bowl, an egg, and a brush. Get my egg, crack it in there. Put my shell in my bowl, chuck that in the bin in a minute. Whisk up my egg. Egg's a bit hard to come by at the moment, I know. So, you only need to use one. And what this is gonna do, we're gonna brush this over the top and it's gonna make a pot go really golden brown and just yummy and delicious. You see that? Nice and whisked. Whisk in there. Pop my fork in there. And this is another fun bit. Again, you might want to say to your younger brother or sister, come on, do you want to have a go at this? So get your brush. If you have a brush, you could use maybe a little bit of, I don't know, like kitchen towel or something, rub it over. Or you could just use the back of a spoon or something just to get it over the top. But a brush is probably your best bet. Don't use a paintbrush. It might taste a bit funny if you use a paintbrush. Right. And I especially want to go around the edges there. You just brush it all over. Oh. And that egg is gonna just make that top so nice and really nice in that golden brown. Don't want to make too much of a mess. Oh, it's quite therapeutic actually. Get that all around, especially on the edges, because the edges are the bits that are thicker. Just spread that egg all over. And then while that's soaking in, just
going to grab that knife again that I had earlier. And again, with the help of an adult, you just want to cut around the sides all that excess pastry. And you might have a little bit to spare. We don't want to waste anything at this time. Always use shortcrust pastry as something you can make a little mini tart. You could get a little tart dish, make a little fruit tart for pudding. Just try not to tear it off so that it comes off the edge of your pie. If there is a little bit like that that comes away, you can just use a little bit of pastry to fix it. Just want to get rid of all that spare pastry. Oh, do you know what? I can probably make two or three little mini pies, mini tarts with this pastry. Maybe get some frozen fruit out the freezer, cook it up, use up whatever we've got left. Yeah, I'm gonna just fix that bit up. Grab my fork again and just push that down, repair the side that's coming apart a little bit. Yeah. Pressing that down. It's not the neatest, but that's what my cooking style is all about. I'm gonna collect up this.
That's so polite. Just ask whatever you'd like me to do.
Collect this up. In a minute, I'm gonna put that in some cling film, save it in the fridge. Right, a bit more egg on the top now that's soaked in. Just that bit on the edge there. Also, what the egg does, it makes it no golden, but it also binds the dough together. And then when the pie is completely cooked, you can just tap the extra bits off and it will look a bit better. But on this side, I think I had a bit of a mishap. Nothing a bit of egg can't cover up. Look at that, yum, yum. I'm just gonna wipe the last bit, a couple more holes, so that steam can get out. So now, next step. Oh, it's a bit hot, actually. I'm gonna use my oven gloves. Next step, I'm gonna put this in the oven for about 40 minutes until the top's really nice and golden brown. And there we have it. Look at it, golden brown, crispy pie. Oh, I can't wait to open this up to see what's inside. You are definitely going to need an adult to help with this because it's going to be hot. But if I cut through this pie, cut my nice big slice, big old slice of pie. Remember, yeah, you should have to get around the side. Here you go, my final little touch. Some leeks. I've got some cabbage there, just cooking away. I'm gonna have that on the side. There you have it. Look at that nice filling in the middle there. Nice edge of that pie. Crispy. All the steam's coming in the camera. Crispy top. There's an extra little bit I put there. Whew. I hope you've enjoyed this recipe I've done for you. And good luck if you try it. Good luck, but yeah, I hope you've enjoyed it. Goodbye.